Good morning, students. I hope you are all fine at home. In the previous video, we have started chapter number 6, formatting a document. We have recapitulated the things again. In the previous video, we have learned how to change a font, how to change a font size in our text, how to take a different types of font, how to apply different fonts in our text. How can we change the font size of our text? How to change the color of a font and how to change the specific color and about the highlighting text. Now in today we are learn about the various formatting we have done options such as bold, italic and underline. B stand for bold, I stand for italic and U stand for underline. You know, we all know very well ki whatever we need to change the document, we need to select the text first. Select the text you wish to change. I have told you B stand for bold, I stand for italic, U stand for underline. These commands are available in the font group. We can select by one. First of all, we need to select the text. Then we click on B, then the overall select is bold. And if I click on I, the all over text is turned into italic. In italic, the text is slightly moved to the right direction. U stand for underline. If we selected U tab, then all the text would be underlined. And then accordingly, the selected text will be modified in the document. And here we learn about the changing text alignment. First of all, I will tell you what do you mean by word alignment. Okay, so we need to select the text you wish to modify. It is all the alignments are available on the home tab. There are four types of alignment. It is available in the paragraph section. The four alignments are align text left, center, align text right and justify. Now we discuss very much clearer what is text alignment. Okay, so alignments, what is alignment? Alignments refers to the positioning of the text on the page. It is always better to set the alignments before typing. We can use select an entire document and then change the alignment of the text. In figure 6.3 there are alignment buttons shown. Alignments refers to the positioning of the text, means it shows where in our document where the text is, what's the position of the text in on page. It is always better to set the alignment before typing. We can also select an entire document, then change the alignment of the text. We can also select the entire text in a one time and then we change the alignment according to our choice. There are four types of alignment. That is, first is align text left. By the word we can easily understand. Align text left. Let we fabricate the word align. That means it shows the positioning. What need to be aligned? That is need to be aligned is text. At which direction the text is aligned, it is aligned into the left. Okay, and the center align, it set the text in center of the left and right. All the text would be in the center. It is mostly used for the title and heading. Align text right, again I am telling you what we want to align. We want to align text in which direction we want to align, that is align on right. It align the selected text toward the right margin. It is often used for placing dates or references in a document. When we return any application in a school or anywhere else in a bank, we need to write the date in the document. So whatever, we need to always put the date in the right hand side of the document. So align text right command is used for placing dates and references in a document. Justify align. Justify word, that means equal, we can say that. It places the text evenly between the left and the right margin and it is mainly used for designing books, magazines and newspapers. Now there is some steps how to align. First we need to select the text. Click any desired alignment button according to our choice. Where this alignment button is shown, it is available in the paragraph group. And observe the changes in the alignment. In the figure 6.4, we select the paragraph first. And then we apply these alignments into our document. There are four types of cases. Okay, the four types of cases. We are learn about the text cases, changing text cases. You can change the case of existing text without retyping in the Microsoft Word by using the change case. What is change case? There are four types of change case available. Sentence case, lowercase, uppercase, capitalize each word, toggle case. Let me describe it. In sentence case, there is an example is also shown. The first letter of the sentence is always capital. In the lowercase, convert the selected text to lowercase. Lowercase means small letter. Uppercase means capital letter. Uppercase, convert the selected text to uppercase. Here is an example. This is a text document. All the letters in a capital letter. Capitalize each word. That means change the first letter of each selected word to the uppercase. Her sentence ka first letter kya ho jayega aapka capital ho jayega. Toggle case. Toggle case convert the case of every selected letter in a reverse manner. That means who's in capital letter, it's reverting to small, and small is changing to capital letter. I hope all of you understand very well, and in the next video we will learn about the more topics in formatting a